There's been no power here in Zabelis for the last almost 48 hours. And there's a little bit of light coming in through the window. And it's time to make some new cushion covers. So I've laid out all of the old material that I took off of our cushions everywhere in the boat. Lay them out flat on the new material. It looks pretty rugged, so it will be able to last a while. It's a solid color, which I really love. I should be able to cut out very roughly the pieces that I need, but I don't want to cut them too exact because I'm going to throw these in the washing machine. All I have to do is throw all this roughly cut material into the wash, shrink it down a little bit.
We're using our ice bucket as our refrigerator. We went down to the boat this morning and made ourselves breakfast with our gas stove.
Scotty!
We haven't had too much luck trolling for salmon, so we're trying more drifting and jigging for fish. We've been pulling up a lot of these yellow eye rockfish from the bottom, and we found out later that we shouldn't actually catch so many of them. They're kind of rare. So luckily we caught this big old ling cod. They have beautiful skin. We also pulled up a bigger and older yellow eye rockfish. Unfortunately, when they come up, the difference in pressure, they don't deal with it very well. His guts came out his mouth. It was pretty gruesome.
There's a pile of fish in the boat and Robi won't stop. I can't stop him.
Yeah,
look at him. He's bloodthirsty. I can't stop him. We're going right into the rocks here.
It's a good idea to sever the jugular vein. So most of the blood flows out and all the stress hormones and the harmful molecules get pumped out of the body with the blood. You can scale and gut the fish, which is the way I like to do it because you get all the juicy knickknacks out of the fish.
Does this work for most kind of fish?
What?
The way you're...
It works for all kinds of fish. You have a bone just there, that's the only bone once you get past. And you just rip it out. The worst of the groupers to do this. The other ones that it all comes all in one. It's even easier on tuna and that's the nice fish. It's clean, it's right to put on the grill.
I got the bile. See? Make a mistake, the bile comes out and it's bitter.
So when you're gutting a fish, the main organ you want to like to avoid is the bladder, which is a green bag, which can be very bitter if punctured and not when the fish is not washed properly afterwards. The heads I like to keep, especially of large groupers or rockfish, because they are excellent for making soup and broths. You just boil the heads and peel the meat off them and yeah, you make excellent soup with them. Parasites are not really a problem if you freeze the fish or if you cook the fish. They can only be a problem if the fish is eaten raw. These particular fish are horrible on the hands. They all burn and... yeah, they just burn like hell.
And here's our doggy, Puffy. It feels like Velcro. So after 3 days, what was it, about 3 days without power?
Yeah.
After about 3 days without power, I was able to put these in the laundry. My pieces, my roughly cut pieces. I'm lucky I did, because this duck canvas actually looks like it shrank a ton. And the edges kind of became very ragged. So giving a couple of inches really did help.